This presentation is all about agriculture and the practices. The agriculture is first of all a science that deals with raising a crop on large scale for some beneficial things like food, fiber, pulses, oil, fruits, etc. First of all, we must understand what is a crop. Crop is a plant that is cultivated on a field area, and it can be of many varieties. It can be cereals like rice and wheat, it can be pulses, it can be oil seeds like groundnut and mustards, it can be fruit, it can be fibers like cotton and jute. To raise a crop, first of all, we need to prepare the field. And to prepare the field, the first step, the very first step of the agriculture practices is preparation of the soil, where we are going to do the two things, that is plowing and leveling. Plowing is a process of breaking and loosening and turning of soil. It is done with the help of the plows in the tractors. We used to take the help of the animals, but now we are going for tractors. Reasons are simple. It is not time wastage. It is we are saving on time. We are saving on energy. And very important thing is that we are doing this business efficiently. Why plowing is done? First thing, it will loosen the soil. So once the soil is loosened, the roots which are going to be developed there can go deep into the soil, into the layers. It will create more space for air, and it will also increase the water holding capacity of the soil. Very important, it will remove undesirable plants that are already there. So it is going to remove all those weeds. It will mix nutrients nicely into the soil and bring the nutrient-rich soil down under the layer to the top layer. Leveling is like spreading jam on the bread. So big lumps of soil after plowing, if they are there, these are called crumbs. Then they are crushed down and broken, crushed or broken, one and the same thing, and spread evenly in the whole field. It is done basically with the help of the levelers. It can be of a metal or it can be of a wooden plank. The method of sowing seeds is a traditional one and the modern one. Since we belong to India, and in India still some traditional methods are prevalent, and we should know about those methods also, that is broadcasting. Basically, the problem is that in this traditional method, the distribution of seeds is not even. It takes a lot of labor. It is very time consuming. And because we are scattering seeds by hands. So we have come across with a new option, the modern option, that is using seed drill. Seed drill is a funnel-like system fitted in the tractor. It will save your time, it will save your efforts also, and very importantly, it will sow the seed at a very correct depth. The method of sowing seeds is a traditional one and the modern one. Since we belong to India, and in India, still some traditional methods are prevalent, and we should know about those methods also, that is broadcasting. Basically, the problem is that in this traditional method, the distribution of seeds is not even. It takes a lot of labor. It is very time consuming. And because we are scattering seeds by hands. So we have come across with a new option, the modern option, that is using seed drill. Seed drill is a funnel-like system fitted in the tractor. It will save your time, it will save your efforts also, and very importantly, it will sow the seed at a very correct depth. Supplying water at regular intervals to the crops is called irrigation. How much water, what will be the frequency at which the field should be irrigated is very important task in this thing. And in today's time when there is a lot of water issues, so that is a time when we have to think about what are the methods of irrigation to be followed. A traditional one or the modern ones. The traditional ones are cheap methods, but they are inefficient. They are time consuming. They need a lot of labor. But the modern methods, they are far more efficient. They are going to save our water, which is the demand, which is today's demand. When we are going for modern methods, the sprinkler system is one of them. It has a network of pipes which are attached to the main pipe. The main pipe will hold the water, and sometimes what farmers are doing, they are adding fertilizers as well as pesticide into it. Then the attached pipes, the network of pipes which are attached to the main one, will have the sprinkler nozzle on the top. So once the water enters, the nozzle will run around and will spray the water in the whole entire field evenly. As the name suggests, drip irrigation. The same ways we see it when one person is being dripped out with glucose. Water is made to fall drop by drop. And this drop by drop is directly going into the roots area where the water is to be absorbed. So this particular method is prevalent in those areas where water is really scarce or very less. And in today's time when we are emphasizing so much on water conservation, this method is the best one.